Are you still using ToUpper and ToLower for your string comparisons? If so, I've got some tough love for you. It's time to stop. It allocates new strings, it's slower, and depending on your culture, it could just flat out lie to you. But let's show a better way, and maybe even talk about how it affects EF Core, SQL Server collation, and even run some benchmarks to show that it really matters and we just don't care about font casing. Let's take a look at what we're actually talking about here. I'm going to go into .NET New Console. And then I'm going to open up Program CS. Get rid of that. And we'll do like var did you subscribe equals I subscribed. Looks like an interface, but it's not. And then we can just console.writeLine. We'll say, did you subscribe dot to lower? And then let's console write line. We'll do did you subscribe dot to lower equals I subscribed. Pretty straightforward code, right? And if we .NET run that, what happens? We should get the string, yep, and true, exactly what we would expect. So what's the problem, Michael? Well, number one is string allocation. Every time you use ToUpper or ToLower, it's actually creating a new string. Now, once or twice, who cares? But if you've got this in a loop, your garbage collector is going to really start hating you. And beyond that, if we're using a different culture, it's just going to lie sometimes. I'll show you what I mean. Let's add a different culture to this code. Let's say thread.current culture, I think it is, equals new culture info. And we'll say tr-tr for Turkish. And if I do that, I'm going to need like using, I think it's a system globalization, something like that, to access culture info. And if I do that, now let's .NET run it. And what do we get? I subscribed and false. Why is that? What happened? Well, in Turkish, in a capital I lowercases differently. It's not an I anymore. It's whatever that thing is. I'm sure there's a name for it, but I don't know it. But it means that our strings don't match. So what's a better way? We can solve all of this with string comparison. Let's update our code to use it instead. So we'll just come in and strip all that out. And we'll say string.equals. And we'll say, did you subscribe variable? We'll hard code I subscribed, because I'm sure you did. And then we'll do string comparison.ordinal ignore case. Close out those. Give me some extras over there. Okay. And just for grins and giggles to make this easier to read, let's break this down on some lines so you can see kind of the pattern. It's like A, then B, then the string comparison. And if we .NET run that, what happens? We should get I subscribed. Notice that I subscribed is still in that Turkish, but it was able to compare that correctly, ignoring culture, and also, in this case, ignoring the case differences. I didn't have to lower did you subscribe because of that ignore case. But we need to think about string comparison like we do our favorite steak restaurant. We don't just walk in and be like, give me meat. No, we got to choose the one that's right for us, right? Maybe we prefer filet mignon or a New York strip or a ribeye. Same applies to string comparison, whether we want ordinal, ignore case, all that kind of stuff. Let's go through them real quick. If we took off ignore case, we have ordinal. Ordinal is the fastest bytewise comparison. It's great for comparing keys or tokens or identifiers, even file names on Windows. That's what you're going to want. But if you add ignore case, what do you get? Well, as you can imagine, the same thing as ordinal, but it ignores the case, right? Next up would be, say, current culture. So if we modified that and said current culture, what we're going to get there is a comparison that actually takes the culture into account. So our comparing the I that gets changed from English to Turkish, that would still return a false there because it's looking at a specific culture. Why would you ever want that? Well, if you're doing a UI, you'd actually want it to think about the culture for that user and what they're seeing. So in that sense, you do want it. There's also the current culture ignore case that does the exact same thing. It's culture sensitive, but it ignores case. Now, all of these have an ignore case variant on it that basically just adds case insensitivity. Insensitivity? Yeah, I said that right. Okay, but next up is invariant culture. And that's a stable culture agnostic option. It's good for logs and persistent data that needs to be consistent everywhere. And we would just do invariant culture or add on at the end of it, ignore case. But let's see a couple of these in action. For instance, I'm going to copy in some code, and you'll see why, because I cannot be bothered to remember how to type those accents. But I've got a super fancy word and a semi-fancy word. Basically just different casings and different accents on them, right? But when I compare those, I'm going to hit save and I'll .NET run. What happens? They both may be true, but which one should be right for you? Well, it depends on your intent. If this is for something a user is going to see or a sort that the user is going to see, you're going to probably want the current culture version. But if this is for logs or something on the back end, ordinal is going to be faster and it's probably the jam you want to run with. But what about other string methods? Things like starts with and ends with? You are in luck, my friend. Let's look at that. Let's say we have var status equals I liked this video. Because who wouldn't? And then we want to say console.writeLine. We'll say status.starts with I liked, and then we'll say string comparison dot ordinal ignore case. Now, if we .NET run that, true, because we ignored case there, so it's just fine, right? What about ends with? You got it. If you guessed that it also has it, it wasn't much of a guess because I already told you it did. But if I said test here and run that, we should get a true and a false because clearly I typed in the wrong thing in the last one. Okay, well, thanks for the info, Michael, but not so fast, my friend. There are other things besides if statements that need to know this. For instance, dictionaries, sets, or lookups can sometimes benefit from having a comparer built into them. Let's see what I mean. Let's say we have a dictionary. Let's say var comments equals new dictionary of string, and then let's pass in string comparer dot ordinal case, no, ordinal ignore case. And then we'll add in, let's add a record onto it and say Mike says nice beard. Just one beard, thanks. All right. And then if we said something like console write line, let's go comments dot contains key. In this case, I'm going to go all caps. What happens? Let's clear this. .NET run it again. What happens? We get true. It does contain that key, even though they had different casings, because I specified ignore case on ordinal. But the same is true for things like a hash set. So if we refactored this into a hash set, and it would just be a string, and then change this to be, let's say, C-sharp Fritz. And then come down here. Well, let's leave it Mike. It should be false, right? It doesn't have contains keys. It would have contains. And let's .NET run. What happens? False. Works like a champ. But wait, there's more. Remember when I said we would get to EF Core? Well, we're there. If you're using EF Core with SQL Server, you probably are using the default collection, which is often case insensitive. Which means any query you send is going to have case insensitivity. I can't say it right two times straight. Built in. So if I was to say var filter equals Michael. And then I said var user equals db, db dot users dot where you, this IntelliSense is killing me, you dot username equals filter. By default, I'm going to get case insensitivity. It's really a struggle. By default, if I'm using that default, compare that collection. But if I'm not using that, I may need to specify the collations. So I could come in and say, bring in using Microsoft.EntityFramework Core, which I don't have installed. There's no database behind this, so I don't know why I'm wasting my time showing you that using statement because it's not installed. We're not going to run this code. But if I were, I could say ef dot, what is it, functions dot collate, and then I would specify u dot username, I believe here. Yeah. And then I would have to type in my phrase, like Latin one. I forget the long strings. I can't even spell it. You see that? Look at this. See what I'm talking about? Like, you need to go look that string up. But basically, you just specify the collation. And then I guess like kind of the last option would be to use something like. So like functions.like. And you could say u.displayName. And then say filter or whatever your text is going to be there. Probably not the best option, but it's out there. But regardless of which one of these options you use, the key point to remember is don't use ToLower in your link statements. Can it handle it? Sure it can. It'll actually turn it into a lower function in SQL. But that means that that function is going to get called for every row in your result set, which is just maddening for me. Don't do it. It makes me sad. And then finally, I promised you that we weren't doing this just because I like uppercase or lowercase fonts. We don't really care about that here. It's all about performance and making our code more gooder. So let's run some benchmarks to show the difference in ToUpper and ToLower versus string comparison. I'm going to paste in some good old-fashioned benchmark.net test. We probably need to go .net add package benchmark. I've got that in my history already. Good. Add that package. Clear us out so we can run this. Let's run through this test real quick and show you what it's going to do. It's basically going to run 1,000 iterations with that constant string of I subscribed. Did you really? Thank you so much. It means so much to me. I appreciate that. We're going to compare it with string equals with ordinal ignore case, and we're going to compare it with ToLower equals that lowercase. With that, let's .NET run it. This is going to take a minute, but not too long, I don't think. It helps when you save the file first. Pro tip for you. Now, you just came here for the .NET magic, and I just gave you the secret. Save the file before you run it. What's happening? Oh, we have to run it. That's right, for .NET. We got to run it in release mode because we don't want the debug tests. We want to see real world, this mug running hardcore. What's the results? Look at it go. What's our results? Tell me now. Look at this. String equals versus ToLower. All you need to know is the lower number, the better. And you can tell that comparison is so much more efficient than ToUpper and ToLower. I mean, allocating strings is expensive business, okay? And now we know not to use ToUpper and ToLower in our string comparison. Use our string comparison. It's almost like it was named that way so that we would use it for the thing. Yeah. If you've got horror stories from using ToUpper and ToLower and memory utilization, all that, I love to hear about that stuff. So let me know. Otherwise, I'll catch you next time.